Kia ora, everyone. My name is Patrick. I'm an educator at Auckland Zoo. The welfare of our animals is always top priority. Okay, we do this by looking at the five domains of animal welfare, staying healthy being one of those. We do this with regular vet checks and making sure they have a great habitat to move around with. This section is called Animal Yoga with Patrick. Hey everyone, the first animal movement we're going to do today is the giraffe. The first thing you're going to do is move your feet nice and far apart with a slight bend in your knee. Okay, we're going to reach all the way down to the watering hole to take a nice drink, just like a giraffe would do. Just go as far as you can or where it's comfortable. Now we're going to reach all the way up to the top of the trees, just like a giraffe would do. Hey everyone, the second animal movement we're going to do is the flamingo. Flamingos love to stand on one leg, so let's give that a try. First thing you want to do is keep both feet on the ground and tuck one of those feet up and balance it on the planted leg. If you're struggling, you can put your wings out to give you some more balance. But if you're really good at balancing, you can pretend that you're preening your wings with your beak. Does anyone know how flamingos get their pink feathers? Let me know in the comments below. Hey everyone, the next yoga move we're going to do is a zebra dust bath. So we're going to get down onto the ground. Okay, we're going to start like this. And then you're going to rock over to the other side. And rock over. And one more time. And that's the zebra dust bath. Hey guys, the next animal movement we're going to do is a relaxed lemur. Lemurs love nice sunny days, and when it's really sunny, you'll find them sitting out there taking in those nice sun rays. So that's what we're going to do. Get those hands out. Just make sure you have your sunscreen on if you're out in the sun. Does anyone know what island you can find lemurs on? Hey guys, the next animal movement is a stretching tortoise. So we're going to get on all fours like this. Okay, I'm going to start like this, and then we're going to reach our long neck up. They have a nice long neck to stretch out to Reese's nice tasty leaves. Mmm, delicious. Try that out. Hey guys, the next animal movement is a basking tuatara. Make sure you find a nice sunny spot, because if you're a reptile, you need to find a warm place to warm up your body. First thing you're going to do, lie on your stomach, and then you're going to push up, arching your back. Don't forget to sit in that nice warm spot. I need some sunscreen. The next animal movement is the lion stretch, also known as the cat stretch. You've probably seen your pet cat or dog do this pretty much every day. Let's give it a go. First thing you're gonna do, like this, okay? You're gonna stretch those long paws out like this, and we're gonna get into a good stretch, okay? Watch your cat or dog do it and give it a try. Hey everyone, didn't think you'd see me here, because I'm being a camouflaging frog. So everyone get in that frog position, and if you're really good at it, you can take a nice big frog jump. One, two, three. The next animal movement is a turtle. So we're going to pretend that we're a turtle and scared of something. You know that if they're scared, they might tuck their head into their shell. So what we're going to do, see something scary, tuck their head in, the coast is clear, and out. Scary, and out. Try that a few times. Hey guys, the next animal movement is going to be the patient kotare. First thing you're going to do, take a nice big step forward. Wah! Okay, and we're going to get those wings out. Whew! Hands up. And the last movement you're going to do, get the head up in the air for a nice balance. 3, 2, 1. And that's your patient kotare. Hey everyone, thanks for watching Animal Yoga with Patrick. Hopefully you've tried a few of those moves. If you can come up with some others, let us know. Thanks for watching.